Hey here, Sarah again. So what we're going to talk about today is two exercises for your upper back, so when you're wearing a backless dress, and your arms. Okay, so your biceps and your triceps. So the first one's a kettlebell swing. This is a kettlebell. You can get them online or in Argos or Elbury's or wherever you want for like 15 euro. So I highly recommend you pick one up. You can do loads of at-home workouts with them. So we're going to start with a kettlebell swing. So Sarah's going to show us. Just do one first, which is and we'll talk about it after. So what's happening here is, she's going to keep her, she's going to pin her shoulders back. So pin her shoulders back at her upper back really tight. Suck her belly button in. Right, and on the way down, she's just letting the weight, she's going a little bit wider on the shoulder with her feet. Let the weight come between and then fire her forward. She's going to use the momentum for her hips to let the weight fly. When she gets to there, so pause there. She obviously can't pause it there. But when you relax. Once she gets up here, she's going to squeeze to make it a proper exercise. She's going to squeeze her glutes, which is her butt, as hard as she can. So do 10 in there. What we're looking for. So upper back really tight, suck your belly button in. When she gets in here, squeeze her butt as hard as you can. You can see it, right? She's squeezing. It's not creepy, is it? Alright, that's it. So that's a kettlebell swing, okay? So what's really important, abs real tight, at the top, squeeze your butt, okay? Second one is a curl press. Wanna grab that, Sarah? This is great for your arms. So you're gonna have the weight by your side, abs real tight, shoulders pinned back. You're gonna curl it up, turn them, push them overhead. Okay? So what you'll find would happen often, so if you want to push them overhead, same way. So oftentimes the weight, your arm will come out here to the sides, put them straight like that. You want them as close to your body, your head as possible. Okay. So what we're going to do a quick circuit. We're going to go, again, not happy with this. We're going to go 20 seconds on a kettlebell swings. We're going to take a 5 second rest. We're going to do 20 seconds of curl to press. Take a 5 second rest. And what you'll do at home is repeat it for 5 to 10 minutes. Sarah, that strikes, we're just going to do it once, okay? Really funny, isn't it?
Yeah.
All right, we're going to rock. So we're going to start with kettlebell swings for 20 seconds. All right, 3, 2, 1, go. Bam. She's going to be out of breath real quick. And again, upper back real tight. Squeeze your butt at the top and keep your belly button sucked in. Alright? That's 10 seconds after. Bam. And when you come up, you don't want to come back too far. So she's going to stop. The minute her hips and knees lock out, she's done. Okay? That's the kettlebell swing. And next one is a curl to press. For 20 seconds. Alright? 3, 2, 1, go. So again, keep the weight close to her head when she comes up. Okay. And what you don't want to do is use any momentum. So keep your elbows close to your body like Sarah's doing. Turn the weight, push it overhead. Real simple. Okay. If you want extra work on the back of your arm when she gets up overhead, she's going to squeeze her triceps with her knees as hard as you can. And she's trembling. And that'll make it a lot more effective. All right, relax. So again, what you're going to do, kettlebell swings for 20 seconds. Take a 5 to 10 second rest, curl to press for 20 seconds, take a 5 to 10 second rest, and repeat it for 5 to 10 minutes or however much time you've got, okay? I guarantee you tomorrow, your upper back, your butt, and your arms will hurt, okay? So, if you want to find out more about us, click the link below. There's a link to our 21-day trial, and we will see you soon.